bosses. This is our country. They are our servants, and our servants are bad, and that's because we are bad bosses.
Are you voting? Are you going to go out and vote for any of those clowns?
Yeah.
Which clown? Clown number one? Which clown?
Trump.
Clown number one, two,
Trump.
Three? Which one?
All the way.
Clown, the chief of the clown, of the clown show.
Yeah.
All right. I got to move, Jerry. Thank you for your call. Appreciate it. Hope we helped you out. Melissa in Oregon, welcome to The Bright Side.
Hi, Ben. How are you?
I'm good. What's going on?
I wanted to mention that I think it would be great if you could find some time to talk about pregnancy on your show.
Okay.
I think it would be nice to hear.
Maybe we'll do that with the omega. We'll do that in this omega-3 discussion. We'll talk about pregnancy because omega-3s are one of the most important supplements for a pregnant woman. You're pregnant, I take it, or you know somebody?
I am.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Just starting my third trimester, and I was wondering what
to do.
Yeah, supplements. As far as supplements and
okay, good. That's a great question. First baby?
No, second.
Okay, well, you're going to notice a difference if you start supplementing now. You're a little at the end of it, so, a lot of the development's already occurred. You really want to be supplementing at the beginning of the pregnancy, but still, you're still going to notice some benefits. Even postpartum, after you give birth, if you start supplementing and you do it carefully and you watch what you're eating, your milk will be better. And mother's milk is nature's, for a human being anyway, it's nature's most powerful food, human mother's milk. For a human being, there's nothing better than human mother's milk as far as growth and repair and building substance, building tissue. And so making sure you have the raw material and you don't have the wrong stuff is important. Number one, if you have digestive issues and you have food allergy issues, those are coming out in your milk, the food and allergens and the antibodies, and your baby is going to be more susceptible. So if you have any digestive issues, leaky gut, you need to eliminate those and make sure you're eating correctly and not eating problematic foods, especially the bad fats. You want to make sure you're staying away from trans fats, hydrogenated fats, and instead, you want to make sure you're supplementing with omega-3s. In fact, I would say that may be the most important. I hate saying the most, but it's certainly one of the most important. Omega-3 fatty acids, fish oil, ALA. Get on your ultimate EFAs from Youngevity. Make sure you're eating fish, although you have to be careful, as we were talking about with the last caller, because the ocean is a little trashed. But still, all of that. But still, fish are very, very contain tremendously valuable nutrients for your milk and for your baby and for you. Not the least of which is iodine, which is another very important supplement for mothers to be. Iodine helps build the baby's brain. So you're going to correct digestive issues, number one. Number two, omega-3 fatty acids. Number three, iodine. Number four, good bacteria. Please make sure your body is loaded with these good bacteria. They are incredibly important for your milk and for your baby. Even as your baby is developing, the bacteria in your gut have an impact on the growth of the baby. So the Biolumin Nightly Essence can be helpful for you, as well as fermented food. Vitamin D, very important for building tissue. Unspeakably important for building all tissue, for growth, for repair, and for building a baby. That means the sun. Vitamin D is also going to be found in food, in fish, and it'll also be found in supplements, but the sun is going to be your best source of vitamin D. The electrolytes in the B complex are also important, if perhaps not in the same, with the same degree of importance as the omega-3s, but they're still important. And then also your fatty vitamins, particularly vitamin A. And also, all the fatty vitamins, vitamin A and D go together. As far as minerals go, zinc is incredibly important for growth and repair for both you and the baby. And then also it helps you stabilize sugar, and keeping your sugar stable is also an important strategy. And that would be chromium, vanadium, selenium, sulfur, not to mention the Bs and the electrolytes. I know there's tons more, and I know it gave you a bunch, but go listen through the archives and review and write, because it's just impossible to be limited with the amount of nutrients that are important for growing a baby, for building a baby. Does that help, Melissa?
It does. Just real quick, is there anything that I should stay away from as far as
foods that cause digestive distress? Or eliminate those entirely, and processed fats. Those are your two bad guys, although any processed food really, but especially fried fats, processed fats, chips and crackers and french fries and grilled fats, all of those things are really bad for you and for your baby.
But supplements are pretty much...
No, supplements, there's no supplements to stay away from, absolutely no,
okay.
Heck no.
Okay. And I can take like melatonin at night if I'm having trouble.
That's not a supplement, but that's a hormone. I don't think that would be a problem, but that's not what we're really talking about here. And the prenatal vitamins that they give you, that is the minimum of the minimum of the minimum wage. It's like working for $3 an hour. Yeah, you might be able to survive, but it isn't all you need, that's for sure.
Okay. Thank you.
All right,
I appreciate
it. Okay, bye-bye. All right, Virginia in Ohio, welcome to The Bright Side.
Hi.
Hi, what's going on?
I was just wondering, what vegetables would you suggest eating for someone who has a low thyroid and diabetic?
Well, all the vegetables, although you do want to be a little bit careful with what they call the cruciferous vegetables for your thyroid. Supposedly, they contain things that tie up the iodine and keep you from, it may have some negative effects on the thyroid, although I have to tell you, I haven't really seen any of that, but that's the rumor anyway. You can bypass that by steaming your veggies, steaming your cauliflower and your broccoli. It really isn't anything specific for diabetes and for the thyroid. Can you turn that? Do you have your radio on, Virginia? I got a weird echo.
I don't.
No? Okay, I think back in the studio, if you could turn that down, I've got a weird echo. I wouldn't worry about avoiding anything specifically, but for the diabetes, what you want to avoid is really super duper sweet fruits. Now, and when I say avoid, I don't mean entirely avoid, but keep your intake of these things down as best as you can. That's really one of the great myths about fruits and vegetables. I said earlier how fruits are not vegetables. And one of the reasons is because fruits are loaded with sugar. And it's a special form of sugar called fructose that is really hard on the liver. So you want to be somewhat careful about the fruits. And I wouldn't say that there's any particular vegetables that you need to use, but just making sure that you're getting all your vegetables is important. Chromium, vanadium, magnesium, fruit, vegetables that have these kinds of minerals, particularly beets. And also nuts, they're not a vegetable, of course, but nuts sometimes can be helpful for people, good sources of these sugar-binding or sugar-controlling nutrients like sulfur and selenium and chromium and vanadium. Thanks for your call, Virginia. I'm gonna try to get one more call in California. What's going on? Welcome to The Bright Side.
Hi. My sister has shingles, and I wanted to help her.
Okay, here's a couple things for you, Ann, and we're out of time, so I'm just going to go fast.
Yeah.
Selenium is the first thing to think about with shingles. Very powerful antiviral. Vitamin C is also antiviral. Make sure she's getting enough vitamin C. But the most important strategy for dealing with shingles is to strengthen the immune system. The only people who get shingles are people who are immune compromised. So making sure you're keeping your intake of foods that throw off immunity, that's the processed foods and food allergens and foods that cause you digestive distress, that's really the most important thing, in addition to an all-around nutritional supplement program that features vitamin C and the B vitamins and selenium, and also, to a certain extent, probiotics, which can have antimicrobial properties. And that's all the time we have for today. Thank you so much for listening, friends. Have an awesome, wonderful, beautiful, spectacular day. We'll talk to y'all later. Bye for now.